They had returned from the strange world. The forest was just as they had left it, except not quite. It seemed that destroying the device at the core of that rift somehow disrupted the illusion, revealing the true path forward. They spotted the white wolf. Without a moment's hesitation, the pair gave chase. A small glade of otherworldly beauty opened before Cereza. This dark forest held secrets yet. Cereza relaxed ever so slightly. A small glade of otherworldly beauty opened before...
Mm-hmm. We need a rest.
Thank you.
It's because they know you're weak.
Cheshire patronized Cereza.
Cheshire, over here! Cool!
In a nearby grove, there was a place illuminated by moonlight. As she approached, the magic brace in Cereza's wrist began to glow.
So I have finally found you, Cereza.
Morgana?
Cereza blinked in disbelief as the ghostly figure of her teacher appeared from within the moonlight.
Thank goodness you're safe. When I realized you'd gone to the forest, I was beside myself with worry. But really, Cereza, to enter the forest despite all my warnings. You even made off with my magic brace. Just what were you thinking?
Although this was only a projection of Morgana, her scolding somehow managed to be even more intimidating than the genuine article. Cereza could only hang her head.
I am looking forward to a thorough explanation once you're home safe. But I'm afraid escaping the Avalon Forest will not be easy.
Morgana's expression was grave. She explained how the fairy's magic turned the forest into a labyrinthine trap, one in which Cereza was currently ensnared. This ancient enchantment was so strong, even Morgana herself could not easily break it.
For now, all I can do is support you from afar. I will begin researching ways out of the forest. You just find a safe place. And try to stay alive until I find a way to save you.
Don't worry, Morgana. Look, I was able to summon a demon of my very own.
Is that... You summoned a demon into your stuffed toy? Cereza... Well, it will have to do. If you are able to wield that demon, your chances of survival will increase greatly. This forest belongs to the fairies. However, if you search carefully, I am sure you will find objects that will help you develop your magic abilities.
What about these sparkly things? I've picked up a bunch of them since I've got here.
Yes, that crystalline structure is a stable source of magical energy. If you feed it to the demon, it may awaken some new powers.
The light of the moon began to wane. With it, Morgana's visage grew faint. It was as if the forest itself conspired to impede their plans.
Cereza, listen well. Demons are weapons which we witches wield, not friends to be cuddled. Remember to treat them as such.
The remaining moonlight faded, and Morgana disappeared. Cheshire was in a foul mood.
What was that? Morgana is my master, and I will not have you speak of her in that way. I feel bad for worrying her, but I don't get why she's so overprotective. I mean, I summoned a demon and everything.
Cereza wished that just once Morgana would tell her she did a good job. She had already forgotten Morgana's scolding.
Well, back to chasing the white wolf. If we get that power, even Miss High and Mighty Morgana will sing our praises. Oh yeah, those little sparkly things. She said they might help you grow stronger. I wonder what that means. What is this?
In one corner was a rock, polished to a shiny finish. This would make a good substitute for the mirror she used when training.
Hey! Without Morgana! breathing down my neck. I might be able to get in some good practice. Worth a try. Does this work?
Thank you. Huh? Thank you.
Let's take a break.
Can't you move any faster? The wolf was getting away and Cheshire was not happy about it.
I'm going as fast as I can! We'd be able to move a lot faster if you would give me a ride on your back!
The demon said nothing. His glare was all the answer Cereza needed.
That's what I thought. Run off to now. What's that over there? Let's go check it out.
All of a sudden, a tough-looking fairy appeared out of nowhere. Cereza was startled, but tried to regain her composure.
Why don't you flock off already and leave us alone?
Cheshire let out a sigh as he pushed past Cereza to face down the fairy.
Who's gonna be the appetizer. And who shall I save for dessert?
Roared Cheshire, his mane rippling and claws extended. The path continued to a line of arching trees which had grown together to form a tunnel. Could it be that the fairies were trying to protect this place? A strange orb atop a pillar. Could this be the elemental core of which the boy in Cereza's dream had spoken? Before it stood the white wolf. Just as Cereza took a step towards the pillar to investigate,
wait! What are you doing?
Leaping from Cereza's grasp, Cheshire lunged towards the wolf.
Stop running and tell us how to get that power already!
Cheshire was fed up with this wild wolf chase. He wanted answers.
Cheshire! Stop! And listen for a second!
Missing his mark, Cheshire's claws struck the elemental core instead. All was quiet until... energy poured from the core like a furious whirlpool. Standing in its midst, Cereza felt a strange power flow through her.
What was that? I feel funny.
Don't hog the power, girl!
Cheshire roared his protest. He wanted his piece of the pie. But what exactly had they released? The pair had gained a new ability.
Is this it? I can go home now?
Cheshire asked excitedly.
No, this is something different. We need to smash 3 more of those things before I can send you back. I'm sure this pair will come in handy for something too. I know. That is why we're following that wolf in the first place.
Speaking of that wolf, where did he go now? To find the other elemental cores, they first need to find him.
I swear, you demons are more trouble than you're worth.
The bickering companions left the remains of the core behind them, heading ever deeper into the forest.
Thank you.